This is a quick video to go over the hailstorm in June 2010. We used a Cessna from Civil Air Patrol that Lima provided to do some assessment from the air. We also did some ground truthing where we actually went to the fields. I worked with about 15 growers to determine what to do with these crops that were damaged. I'm going to try to provide you both the ground and the aerial together. It's difficult to figure out how to present this. So once we did get off the ground, in the area just immediately around Regal Field, you could see some of the crop damage. Doesn't look too bad. This would probably be some moderate damage. You can't quite see the soil there. As we got out, we saw some rye that was flattened. Most notably the wheat, a couple hundred acres of wheat in this area that was pretty much flattened. You can see where the storm pretty much brought the wheat down. Easy to see when you drop down into the wheat to see the wheat on the floor. We estimate about 70% loss of the wheat, maybe a 30 bushel crop now. Also in this field there was some carumba applied to the field. It's a fungicide heading. And that was easily seen from the aerial photo, exactly where the producer put it on. Soybeans almost canopied out, now with very few leaf tissue. Looking across the field, we probably had 80% removal of the leaves. Most damaging. There was some synchrony applied in the right part of the field, one strip of it, but you can see the lack of vegetation there. As you kind of pan through these areas, there were some just massive leaf loss, primarily from the hail, that caused issues. The physical beating of the heads of the wheat, and that certainly dropped onto the floor, and we lost quite a bit of wheat. I estimated about 60 bushel on the ground, maybe a little, you know, tough to estimate, but I figured about a 30 bushel crop. An aerial photo of a soybean field here that was completely bare of Nelson Sensenigs. This is the Reed Hoover farm with some moderate damage. And again, here's a snapshot of what it should look like. And then here's some barren areas of the Schaefer farm with some beaten sides. This was very common in all of those farms. You had to cut it in half to even get the stage on it because there was very few leaves there. Also, the stand was physically broken off from side winds. Just a real terrible case of it. And then when you go to the air, that same field I'm standing in, you can see the lack of vegetation in there. This is the farmer brush hogging that field down and replanting. This is another shot of a sweet corn farm that had been injured, that had been affected. Here's a swath of some forestry that had been taken out. And we had structural damage to several of the buildings. All total, the storm cost about 26 farms, $560,000, and they might not be the true cost when you add in the loss in forage quality and structural damage.